فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
So Muqatti has that additional thing that the rest don't have. Okay? Okay. And what's the ruling in terms of, what's the example for a hadith which is a munqati? A lot of examples can be given of a hadith which is a munqati. The hadith which is a munqati is ما رواه التلميذي, that which التلميذي narrated from the man الحجاج ibn Ardat, who narrated from عبد الجبار ibn Wa'il ibn Hujr عن أبيه قال استكرهت امرأة على عهد رسول الله فدرى عنها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الحد. الحديث أبو عيسى التلميذي said هذا حديث غريب. This is a hadith which is غريب. وليس إسناده بمتصل. And the chain of narration of this hadith is not connected. Why? عبد الجبار ابن وائل ابن حجر he didn't hear from his father وائل ابن حجر. He hasn't heard from his father. Because he was born لأنه ولد بعد أبيه بستة أشهر. He was born after the death of his father 6 months. So he never narrated from his father. So this hadith is منقطع ضعيف لا يحتج به. It's ضعيف, disconnected. It cannot be taken because لتخلف شرط من شروط القبول وهو الاتصال. The condition of connection is missing here, which is that the chain of narration should be connected. Okay? Those four that we just mentioned are what? They are the type of سقط which is ظاهر. أما واضح, whichever you call it. ظاهر or واضح, doesn't matter. So now what we've taken is the hadith when it's saqtu, the disconnection is ظاهر أما واضح. We finished. Alhamdulillah. We're now going to go to أنواع الصقط. We're now going to go into the types which are disconnected, which is خفي. Okay? We finished the first types of disconnection. Now we're going to go to the two types which are المدلس, and we're going to go to المرسل الخفي. Pay attention. She's going to mention it. Now. And who connect that type, the four types that we just mentioned, any student of knowledge who studies hadith can really tell it. He knows it. Because it's the reason why it's called ظاهر, apparent, واضح, it's clear, everyone can see it. Not really that big. أحد طلبة العلم له أدنى عناية بالحديث وعلوم ورجاله. Anyone who has any thought, any efforts, any understanding of science of hadith will be able to realize it. Which ones? We took المعلق, المرسل, المعضل, and منقطع is simple to tell. Now, this one is the real one. These are the hardest ones. They're the trickiest ones. And we need to realize. فالأول, the first one is. The first one for what? The first one for the السقط الخفي. First one. يدرك بعدم التلاقي. يدرك. He reaches the era of that person, but he doesn't meet them. They're at the same era, but he's at the same time as him. They reach the same era, but they didn't meet each other. So the person who's narrating and the individual who he's narrating from, لم يدرك عصره. Sorry, يدرك بعدم التلاقي. Sorry, the first one is that now is بعدم التلاقي بين الراوي وشيخه لكونه لم يدرك عصره. First one, the first one is he didn't meet his time. They're not same era. That's the first one. We're gonna mention it. The first one is that the Sheikh rahimahullah mentions is that which they have not met at the same era. Now, so all of the four types that we've just taken right now, which was the mu'dal, the mursal, sorry, the mu'allaq, the mursal, the mu'dal, and the munqati'. They were all zahir or the wadih, which is a saqt al-zahir or saqt al-wadih. And we finished it. The Shaykh is now going to go into another type, which is al-khafi. The disconnection can be what? Unclear, khafi, hidden. And that's two types. It's mudallas and the mursal al-khafi. Mudallas and the mursal al-khafi. What is the difference between the two types of disconnection? What does it mean, apparent and this and that which is not apparent? What it means is that the first type that is wadih, clear, the four that we mentioned, which are clear. First of all, it is clear in the sense where يُدْرِكُهُ طَلَبَهُ أَحَادُ الطَّلَبَهُ. Any individual student of knowledge, مِمَّنْ لَهُ أَدْنَى عِنَايَةٌ, any person who has any effort or ability, بِالْحَدِيثِ وَعُلُومِهِ, its sciences, وَرِجَالِهِ, and its the men regarding it, would know it. It's not something that requires a lot of knowledge in depth. Which is the four that we mentioned, the مُعَلَّق, the مُرْسَل, the مُعْضَل, and the مُنْقَطِع. The reason why it's very easy and it's apparent and everyone can know it is because the two people did not meet. They didn't meet. Okay? The two people, and that's what Ibn Hajar said, فَالْأَوَّلُ يُدْرِكُ بِعَدَمِ التَّلَاقِي. We know it because they never met. They never met each other. Because they didn't meet each other's era, each other's timings. Simple. That's what everyone can tell. Fulan was born this year and this one will die this year. So never met. The Mu'allaq is like that. The Mursal is like that. The Mu'dal is like that. And the Munqata is like that. That's easy. They didn't live at the same time. Two different eras. This was born when this one died. Simple. The next type, which is وَمِن ثُمَّ احْتِيجَ إِلَى التَّارِيخِ. So because of the first type, the Sheikh says, all you need is the history and the type, the birth and the deaths. لِتَضَمُّنِ مَعْرِفَةِ مُوَالِيدُ الرُّوَاتِ وَوَفَيَاتِ وَالْحَلَاتِ وَاخْتِلَاطَاتِ وَغَيْرِ ذَلِكَ. When was Fulan born? When did he die? When was he born? When did he... So any Talib al-Ilm can tell that type. The first four types that we mentioned. All the student needs to do is go to the books of وَفَيَاتُ الْأَعْيَانِ, the years that the people were born and died. كُتُبُ الرِّجَالِ. Just look at Fulan, when was he born? When was Fulan died? Simple. Like in the second type, no. The second type, they met. Sorry, they lived at the same era. Are you guys with me? The second type, they lived at the same era. Like there's a difference between the two themselves. Please, I want you to understand. Don't worry, we're going to go into details. Don't worry. Put your pens down. Stop writing. Just listen. I'm going to tell you. The next type, which is called the khafi. Okay, this is the trickiest part. They lived, both of them, Mudallas and the Mursal al-Khafi. Pay attention. Imran, stop writing. Al-Mursal, the Mursal, the Mudallas and the Mursal al-Khafi. Both of them, how are they different from the Saqtul al-Wadih al-Zahir? Lived, this one, these guys are in the same era. But then what's the difference between these two then? If they were both, one of the two, not only did they live in the same era, but they actually met one another. And the other one is just that they lived in the same era. Does that make sense? So the Sheikh is going to tell us which one is the same era and which one met. So pay attention. Two people lived in the same era. If he narrates from him, scholars know if he did heard the hadith from him. Now that's probably easy because they lived in the same era. It's so hard. It's very hard to tell. Two people who lived in the same era who could have met one another, huh? Who could have met one another, scholars would know if they did meet each other or not. But what's more harder is two you know they met, to know if they heard from each other a particular hadith. To know that this was one of the hadith in which he heard from him. That's what the Sheikh is going to now tell you. Okay? So we finished the first type. The first type is knowing they didn't live at the same era. They didn't live at the same time. Now you can write. The first type is they did not live in the same era. It's simple as all you need to do is what? احْتُوجَ إِلَى التَّارِيخِ. You just need to go back to the tarikh and you'll learn. The second type, no, they lived at the same era. They lived at the same time. Na'am. And that's why it's hard to tell. And that the ulama of hadith, the muttali'una, the scholars who observe عَلَى طُرُقِ الْحَدِيثِ وَعِلَلِ الْأَسَانِيدِ لِخَفَاءِ وَغُمُوضِ. It's very hidden, it's very hard to tell. And it's two types, it's mudallas and the mursal al-khafi. So let's start with the mudallas, because the Sheikh started with the mudallas. The مدلس is اسم مفعول من التدليس. It's اسم مفعول from تدليس. And in Arabic language, that the word تدليس means كتبان, is to hide. عيب السلعة على المشتري. It is to hide a problem in a product in which you're trying to sell to somebody. It's called تدليس. تدلس. You know there's a defect in your product. It has a problem. And you're trying to sneak into somebody's pocket, trying to make them buy it from you. You know there's a problem in it. This is called تدليس in the Arabic language. You're hiding it from them. And it comes from originally, أصل التدليس is what? مشتق من الدل من الدلس. It comes from the word دلس. And دلس in the Arabic language is what? ظلمة, the darkness of the night. It's when the dark, اختلاط, when it mixes, the light, the night mixes and overcomes the daytime. That's what it means in the Arabic language. Go to the Qamus and that's how you find it. Okay. واصطلاحاً it means ما أخفي عيبه, it is anything that its shortcoming is hidden. على وجه, in a form, يوهم, that will make you think أنه لا عيب فيه, that will make you think that there's no shortcoming in it or there's no defect in it. It's to hide something, a problem that is in a thing, in a hadith, but you're trying to present it in a way that will make the person not think that there's a problem in it. That's why it's called it. Because the narrator, what he does is, لِمَا أَخْفَى وَجْهُ الصَّوَابِ, he hid from the people the reality of the hadith. So that's why they call it تدليس, because he darkened it. And at the dark, you can't tell what's, how things are. So that's why they use the word دَلَس, تدليس, because it's dark, it's not clear now. The matter is not clear. The تدليس is five types. Two are the most important. There are five types. There's تدليس الإسناد, there's تدليس التسوية, there's تدليس القطع, there's تدليس العطف, there's تدليس الشيوخ, and the two most important one is the first and the last one. تدليس الإسناد and تدليس الشيوخ are the most important two. Those are the two most, those are the two most common types of tadlis. So inshallah, we will only mention those two types. بإذن الله الكريم. We'll only mention تدليس الإسنادي and تدليس الشيوخ. Even that though there's تدليس التسوية, تدليس القطع, تدليس العطف, تدليس الشيوخ. Should we mention all five? Or should we just mention two? Okay, we'll mention all five of them, inshallah. We'll mention all five. تدليس الإسناد. What is تدليس الإسناد? What does it mean to do تدليس الإسناد? First of all, do we all understand the definition of what تدليس means? Okay. تدليس الإسناد means. The scholars, they defined the word تدليس الإسناد is, of people of hadith, scholars of hadith, many types of definition they gave. Every definition you find, there's a look to it. It's not jami'un mani'un. There's all look to it. So inshallah, the we're going to take the best definition, and that is going to be the definition put by al-imamaini, two imams, Abi Ahmed ibn Amr al-Bazzar, and also Abu al-Hasan ibn Qattan, rahimahullah. Their definition is as follows. أن يروي الراوي, it is that the narrator narrates a hadith, عمن قد سمع منه, from a person in which he heard from, قد سمع منه, ما لم يسمع منه, something that he has not heard from him. It's a narrator narrates a hadith, عمن, from a person, قد سمع منه, a person who he has heard from a matter in which he hasn't heard from him. I'll explain it. من غيري, without him, أن يذكر أنه سمع منه, without him mentioning that he heard from him. Let's explain the definition. It means, which is تدليس الإسناد, the narrator will narrate a hadith from his sheikh, his own sheikh. قد سمع منه بعض الأحاديث, he has heard from him what? Some ahadith. He narrates from his teacher, who we know he's generally met him, and he narrated from him. So the first part where he says, أَيَّرْوِ الرَّاوِي, it is that a narrator narrates a hadith, عَمَّنْ قَدْ سَمِعَ مِنْهُ, from a person who he heard from, meaning generally he heard from this person. Generally, he had heard from him. But this he hasn't heard from him. ما لم يسمع منه something which he hasn't heard from him. This hadith which he done the tadlis in, he hasn't heard from him. He has heard it from another sheikh of his. But he drops that sheikh in which he heard it from. And he would drop him out to connect it to his own sheikh so he can make the chain of narration shorter. Give you an example. Our brother Faisal comes to the lesson. Okay. He comes to the lesson. He's part of the class. But one day he chooses not to come to the class. And let's say my lesson is a sitting where we narrate a hadith. And the hadith in which I narrate every single day, I'm not going to repeat it tomorrow. We're going to keep it moving. Okay? So what happens is Brother Faisal says he's missing from the gathering. So now he narrates from his sheikh, which is Imran. Because anyone who you heard a hadith from becomes your teacher. So Faisal narrates a hadith from Imran, and Imran tells him that he was in the gathering. So Imran was at the gathering that day. Are you with me? Mm-hmm. Imran was at the gathering that day. But Faisal wasn't. But generally, Faisal, does he come to my lessons? Yes. Does he hear my hadith? Yes. So he is a person who narrated from me. Just that he hasn't narrated this particular hadith from me. So what does he do? He drops out Imran. What does he do? What he does is he drops out Imran from the chain of narration. So Faisal is not at that particular gathering. He's absent from it that particular day. The particular hadith that was narrated, he wants to know what it is. So he goes to Imran and says, Imran, you tell me the hadith. So Imran chooses to tell him the hadith. Faisal, on the other hand, he drops out Imran, because he's doing tadlis. He drops out Imran, and he jumps to who? He jumps to me directly. But now, he can't say that I told him, because he'll become a liar. He'll become a kadhib, a liar. So what will he use? He would use the word qala and an. Qala means Abdul Rahman said. Did Abdul Rahman really say it? Yes, he did say it. Because, not to him, but he did say it. To who? You don't know who he said it to. He hid that person who said it. Who? Does that make sense? This is called Tadlisul Isnad. It's the first type. It's called Tadlisul Isnad. He will use the word Qala and what? He would use the word Qala and An. Why would he do that? لِيُوهِمَ غَيْرَهُ أَنَّهُ سَمِعَ مِنُهُ To trick the people, to make the people think that he heard it from me directly. But he would choose not to use, like لَا يُصَرِّحُ بِأَنَّهُ سَمِعَ مِنُهُ He would choose not to use the word حَدَّثَنِي سَمِعْتُ He would choose not to use that. Okay? Ha. So now we realize that the Tadlis is what? Tadlis is a person who he lived at the same era with. And also what? Met. Ha. Whereas Mursalul Khafi is just that they lived at the same era. He didn't meet him. He did not. That's the farq between the tadlis, the tadlis and the difference between tadlis and mursalul khafi. An example of this is a hadith example which I'm gonna give you. I'm gonna give you guys an example of a hadith regarding this. Imam Hakim narrated in his kitab Ma'rifat Ulum al-Hadith with his chain of narration to Ali ibn Khashramin. Ali ibn Khashramin. Then he said, Qala lana ibn Uyaynata. He said, Qala lana Ali ibn Khashramin said, Ibn Uyayna said to us, Ani Zuhri. Ani Zuhri. Ibn Uyayna said, Ani Zuhri. From Zuhri. Faqila lahu, it was said to him. To who? Ibn Uyayna. Sufyan ibn Uyayna, it was said to him. سمعته من الزهري Did you hear it from Zuhri? فقال لا No, I didn't hear it from Zuhri. Who did this? Sufyan ibn عيينة He was asked Did you hear it from Zuhri? قال لا No ولا ممن سمعته ولا ممن سمعه من الزهري I didn't hear it from Zuhri Not even the person who heard it from Zuhri حدثني عبد الرزاق told me عن معمر from معمر عن زهري how many people did he drop? Two he dropped to عبد الرزاق بن همام الصنعاني and he dropped to معمر بن راشد two people زهري ففي هذا الحديث ابن عيينة he dropped to two people between him and زهري what did he do? تدليس الإسناد what did he do? تدليس الإسناد he done تدليسه الإسناد.